Big O Productions here, coming to you with another video. And ow, I just banged my elbow on the bloody table and that hurt. And today we are talking about Call of Duty Infinite Warfare. Now behind you is some gameplay of Black Ops 3. I do decent, actually I do pretty well. I think all games I at least get 30 kills, so I do pretty decent, you know. Thought I'd bring this for you, but we are finally talking about Infinite Warfare. We'll be doing a trailer breakdown in a separate video. Also, be talking about COD 4 a little bit right at the end of this video, but then I'll do a whole nother video on it because there are some changes. But Infinite Warfare, so COD XP just finally finished, well, the competitive side, but the whole event finally finished. GG's to Envy for winning. I was hoping my team Optic would win, but they went out in a close game to Cloud9. So GG's Cloud9, they went down 3-2 eventually, but that's just the way. They were favorites to win, but they just couldn't pull it off right in the end. It's close. SND 6-5. Formal almost won that 1v1, just couldn't do it. But that is not why you guys have clicked on the video. You have come to see some Infinite Warfare. Well, not see, but hear about Infinite Warfare. So with COD XP came people playing Infinite Warfare, the trailer of Infinite Warfare multiplayer coming out, as well as also people got to play Zombies Infinite Warfare, Infinite Warfare Zombies. So that will be also another separate video, but this video we are just here talking about it. So here's just a little thing they announced as part of when they showed off the trailer at COD XP. Infinite Warfare multiplayer introduces an all-new combat rig system, hundreds of weapons, never-before-seen high-tech equipment, and unique prototype weapon crafting to fuse immersive, frenetic action with innovative new gameplay experiences at every turn. Now, that sounds wacky, crazy, amazing, all of the above. I'm going to be breaking it down. So basically, I'll read the little paragraphs and explain more. So, each of the rigs is outfitted with distinct payloads that boost player effectiveness and lethality in combat. Rigs allows for players to have three persistent perks, which are called traits. Players get to pick one payload and one trait to create their twist on a play style. This is basically kind of like Specialist, but it is different. Now, I want to talk about this straight away. This is not a reskin of Black Ops 3. This is not Advanced Warfare and Black Ops 3 having a baby. If anything, it's a mix of Modern Warfare 2 and 3, so pretty much the Modern Warfare series had a threesome with Black Ops 3 and Ghosts, and they came out to get this game. Now, I have looked at it and I think it looks good. That's my initial reaction. It looks good. Am I hyped more for COD 4? Yes, but Infinite Warfare still looks good. So these rigs are basically kind of like Specialists, but they are different. In the video, you'll see there's a whole lot of different breakdowns. Now, Specialist abilities, there are one or two that I've seen that are the same. So they have an overdrive, that is called overdrive, and a glitch that I think that is called a glitch. But two things, they are not copying Black Ops 3. This game has been in creation, in development for over 3 years. It's not like they just started yesterday. It has been worked on for 3 years. Alright, so everyone needs to stop getting their bloody knickers in a twist and worry about, oh, they're copying Black Ops 3. They're not copying Black Ops 3. Boo-hoo, you don't get the old movement system, alright? I like the new movement system. Yes, was the old movement system better? Probably. But you know what? Who cares? This is how we've got it. This, I think, is a step to the future. This is for the new audience. A new audience coming to Call of Duty. Alright. Sorry, I went on a bit of a rant there. So, yes, you have perks, which are a bit, they're called traits. They're not like Specialist abilities. That's where you get to choose your payload. I've seen one where there's a robot one instead of a scythe. Basically, and this is completely different design. So these guys look completely different. Want to get that straight out, straight away. Looks completely different. Yes, there's boost packs. The space thing is just more creativity with maps. It does not mean you are floating around in space. As far as I've seen. Just gonna put that out there. So Payload, this guy, he pretty much turns into a dog, a robotic dog, runs around. There's like, you bring out a riot shield and you just go on a charge. There's a glitch, there's like this laser weapon. There's so many mad things I've seen. There's a new grenade thing called, actually I'll go through that later. But actually, no, I'll go through it now. There's a new grenade, a lethal grenade called a black hole detonator or something. And you throw it down. It's almost like a bouncing Betty, but it kind of, yeah, so it kind of goes off, I think, when it plays nearby, and it spawns this mini black hole that sucks people in, but it can suck you in just as your own frag can kill you. These traits can be anything. Moving on to traits, these traits could be anything from, it's not a glitch, sorry, that's your choose payload. It can be, like, better accuracy. Like, there's a whole lot of different, payloads and everything. I will list videos down below that give good breakdowns of it all. Two of Ali A's videos. I'll list COD 4 videos down in my COD 4 video as well. I'm going to list some sniping montages, some gameplays, everything like that in the description so you can go find out more from the guys that went there. Alright, this video has 3 weeks. The Warfighter supports the team by getting fast kills, quickly getting to the objective as always being on the offensive. Its core payloads includes a rapid, this is the gun thing I was talking about, the rapid fire spread shot firearm that has ricochet bullets. Its trait makes score streaks require a higher point value to attain, but they don't reset when you die. Now that is like on modern on the old games, on Modern Warfare, where you had not death streaks, but you had, there was three different types of streaks you could choose. There was assault, support, and then there was a perk one, which I think it was just a perk or specialist or something. And the support, they weren't quite as good. Like, there were some, there were different perks, and there were some the same, some were different. The assault ones were always better, but the support ones you would still get through no matter what. Now they didn't add points to that. They ended up getting rid of that because, especially if you're a good player, to get those streaks, like, it just becomes OP, and so there's so many juggernauts running around. The Merc Rig is designed to clear enemies quickly and with authority. It's full charge. This is the riot shield charge I was talking about. Payload includes an armored riot shield that lets you rush enemies and penetrate their defenses. The Infusion trait will regenerate health faster when damage is taken, so you can stay in a firefight for much longer. Now that is one of the traits. That is just the trait they like pair up with each other. Finally, the FTL rig is all about being an assassin. It is outfitted with experimental tech and represents the evolution in covert guerrilla ops. It's a racer payload completely. This is like the Annihilator, but it is different. It like vaporizes them. Completely vaporizes enemies with a compact incinerating handgun. The power slide trait enhances the speed and distance of the slide. It is like the Annihilator, but it is different. The Annihilator is more like, if we go back to Black Ops 2, it's more like the cowboy type. Oh, I can't remember what it's called. I'm gonna search it up now. But yeah, it's more like that, where this is more like a deagle, Desert Eagle. The Python, that's what it's called. The Python pistol from Zombies. That's what it more like. That's the comparison, I guess, for you guys. There'll be videos listed below so you can watch everything. Now I'm going to talk about what I've seen in multiplayer gameplay, everything like that. So it is very similar to Black Ops 3 movement system with a mix of Ghost, HUD. So yeah, there is a mix of different games in there, but I like, but why I said Modern Warfare is because it looks like a lot of Modern Warfare guns have been revamped and changed around to be in there. Now, there's no direct remake like in Black Ops 3. They remade the Peacekeeper, they remade the MG40. I don't think there's any direct remake other than the Ripper from Ghost. Remember the DLC weapon that was a submachine gun, but when you switch out mode, could be a assault rifle. There is guns like that. There is a sniper rifle that turns into pistols. Sniper rifle that turns into like an SMG or like a machine pistol, or whatever. There's an assault rifle that turns into akimbo pistols, and they're machine pistols as well. There's a whole range of stuff that it looks pretty mad. Score streaks look pretty similar. There's a few different things. There's a Trinity rocket, which is like a multiple shot hellstorm, just a bit harder to control, because the shots take longer. What else? Oh, there's a new game mode. Now, it looks very similar to Uplink, except for the fact that you have to actually just hold on to the ball. So you pick up the ball, and it's basically like a satellite drone, and it's uploading. Not Uplink, uploading to, like, something I have no idea what it's uploading to. But, yeah, and so you've got to hold on to it for your team, and, like, it's the same as Uplink where it comes up on the map. Like, it is pretty cool. So, but yeah, the guns feel very similar to, they feel very similar to a normal Call of Duty gun that you'd expect in Black Ops 2, but a different, animations, different shots. But see, on the energy weapons, because I know people have been confused about these, and a lot of people don't like them, I'm gonna have to say. But yeah, so like a lot of the terminology is still familiar. A UAV is still a UAV. So here we go. They have directed energy weapons, but we still also have ballistic weapons. Directed energy weapons have recoil. Yeah, they fire. Yeah, see these guns. It's not like it is different. They. It feels, from the looks of it and from what people said, it feels like a normal Call of Duty. Sniping good, I haven't found out whether it's aim assist, but the sniping looks good. All the snipers, Optic Plumage, like the FaZe guys, they all, well, from what I've seen, anyone that snipes said they like it. It looks cool, it looks good. So yeah. Tactical nukes, I've got a nuke, yeah. Even though it's technically a de-atomizer strike, epic laser from the sky, naming definitely helps with that. So here we go. So here's the whole space thing. So there's a map called Frontier, and I've actually seen gameplay of this. When they're in zero gravity, so when you shoot someone, they start floating up. We have the fiction, and then this is like a developer talking about it. We have the fiction that the players are wearing gravity boots. As long as you're alive, you'd move like you'd move in a Call of Duty game. We wanted another layer of flavor to it, to sell and succeed on the space fiction. That's where we get into dynamic entities in the map, the bodies that float around when you kill them. We have that in another map that we haven't shown yet as well. So there we go. Everyone's worrying about space. It feels like a Black Ops 3 game. Alright, it feels like a Black Ops 3. Actually, the movement even looks more similar to a normal... like a normal, the older Call of Duties, just with the new system of war run, boost jump. There's a movement bar. It's different. All the animations are different. Although I have to say the payload looks very. I do have to say it does look very similar. When it comes up to click the left and right button. But yeah. So I'm just trying to scan through here. Okay, so here we go. So we know everyone knows the message of the day. They have message of the day notices that will come up and introduce you to new mechanics in the game. So they'll introduce you to directed energy weapons, crafting, and mission teams. We can customize those per player depending on what point you're at in the game. So that looks interesting. That really does, the whole idea of crafting. I have no idea, maybe, and everyone's going to think of Minecraft and everything like that, but I think it's more going to be, you might get to mix weapons together, and that I like. Yeah, so here we go. He's talking about the controversy over people thinking it's like Ghost. So certain the question is asked, if you're good at Ghost, say, will you get good at this pretty quickly? Certain aspects of Ghost. Ghost is a slower paced, less directed Call of Duty experience. Infinite Warfare is more about getting into the action quickly, getting those head-to-head engagements. That's exactly about Black Ops 3, so everyone needs to stop crapping on it. There's certain maps in Ghost like that, but not all of them. People are going to feel more directed here, like the map is guiding them. Players will be able to adapt. If you're a slower paced player, there are places you can post up, places you can hang back and engage. But the maps will push engagement more. They have more choke points. A choke point is basically when there's a point that as soon as you get in, if there's an enemy on an enemy, there's no real way. It has to be a direct gunfight. A choke point is especially when you can choke people up. So if you can get there, if you can just keep killing them spawn, that's the way spawn traps work, because you use certain choke points to choke them off. some things from Black Ops here as well. Just your cherry picks and features that seem to be like war rhyme for sure. With the movement going into the future, we felt like the Black Ops Evolution of movement was extremely successful. We wanted to build on that. A lot of Call of Duty games have done that. We had the goal of changing the face of Call of Duty, but we also want to be an evolution of Call of Duty. The things that worked in previous games, we happily adopt and improve on them. One example is Pick 10. Yes, they still have Pick 10 in custom cars. You had to play, we removed wild cards because we felt like they were cumbersome to slot in and out and manage. Yes, actually, I'm not sure how I feel about that. Oh, okay, yeah, you can quickly slot in an item and it just costs you points. You can remove it and get them back. It's streamlined, that's Pick 10 interface. We take that approach to everything, but we take them as a system and say, we love that system, but what? Okay, so I think what they mean here, and this is really interesting, and I really like this, is that they're saying that the Pick 10 system, that you don't have wild cards, so you don't have to, and you want to add in extra attachments. So, yes, I've seen this in games, I was wondering about it. So basically, what this means is that When you want to add extra attachments, that's fine. That's just going to cost you extra points. You have to then add an extra point for each extra thing you want to do. So it's giving you full customization here. But you've got 10 points. So that means you can... That's good. I like that. That really helps for, especially esports, actually. I reckon esports gonna like it. One thing I've heard is that Theta Sports is not coming back. I'm pretty sure this is confirmed. Theta Mode. Now, this is not as... This wouldn't mind the average COD player. For the guys that like to post on YouTube, this may be a bit annoying, obviously, because they have a good game, they're not recording. Like all the games you see now are brought to you by Theta Mode, so... Yeah. I'm not sure why they've taken that. Apparently it's because of the lag in game, because obviously it's saving every game. So if that's what they're doing, if that was, because I know Black Ops 3 has just some general issues with lag and slow games, you could have like a perfectly working fine Xbox or PS4 or really good PC, and you can still have moments of lag and moments of issues depending on what's going on. Now, I hope there is more support for PC on the Infinite Warfare. I'm getting both games. I will, as soon as the day comes out, basically. Let's check what date it is. What day it's going to be. November 4th. So, the 4th is going to be the Friday. Okay, so what I'm gonna do then, that's a Friday, so this is telling you all right. Actually, I'll talk about another video, but if you guys have stayed around for this video, because it looks like it's going to be a decent long video, there will be... there will be videos all... editing and uploading videos all night that night, so I got a youth, so there'll be no youth or anything. I will get there. I will be basically recording videos that whole afternoon as soon as I come home from school. I'll probably actually catch the bus. Oh, I can't even think to pick it up. I'm not 15 for another 5 days. Okay, well, I may get a mate to pick me up who's 18. I get him to pick me up, and I will go pick up the game, and then I will play it the crap out of it just for you guys, just so we can get it all under control, and so you guys have videos to watch of the new game. I'm just scouring through here looking for anything else, but yeah, guys, that's pretty much what I've seen. All the weapons look good. There are some better weapons than others. Obviously, there's weapons that fit every play style. We haven't seen every weapon. We haven't seen every map. The Terminal remake looks amazing. There are a few things that's changed. One big thing, if anyone remembers, the big windows going through. So if you're outside, you're looking the way the plane directs to the building. There were big glass windows. Anyone that's played Terminal know what I'm talking about. Big glass windows you should be able to shoot into. So you could still pick those off. Snipers could try and sit behind cover there and pick them off, or sit outside and pick them off. Now, there's only two of them are open. The what? So the the end one. So the one close to that building where you used to be able to jump on top to as long as you climbed up the ladder, which now you can just boost up to. And the one right near the entrance to the now what's now the space. Because you can't talk properly. It's just not a plane, it's a spaceship. But it's still the same layout, guys. Don't freak out, don't worry. The layout's exactly the same. But yeah, so those two middle windows in our gate off, you may be able to shoot them through them with FMJ. I don't think anyone's tested that yet. But I don't know. So I'm really hyped for COD Infinite Warfare. And I hope you guys are too, honestly. Like, I really hope you guys are hyped for Infinite Warfare. I hope you guys enjoyed the gameplay. Depending on how much gameplay I could find that was good, you may just get some crappier gameplay that wasn't as good. I hope you do get good gameplay in the background. I'll try and get the best. I'll grind out as many as you... I'll be grinding out a whole lot of videos soon because, especially I've got holidays coming up. Over the holidays, I'm going to try and grind out as much, but I will be away one weekend. So I'm going to try and have two videos to be released that weekend while I'm away. And yeah, but with exams and assignments and stuff too, and got to make sure I'm all on top of those and everything. But thanks guys for watching. If you liked it, please give a massive thumbs up down below. And actually, I want you to only like the video if you like Call of Duty Infinite Warfare. So if you like it, give it a thumbs up. If you don't, no, don't give me a thumbs down, but comment. Comment why exactly you don't like it. And if you don't like the video, then obviously disliked, and again, but I want you to tell me why you didn't like the video, but constructive criticism, guys, so I can work on my videos. Thank you, guys, for watching. If you liked it, please give a massive thumbs up down below. We are at 72 subscribers and nearly 2k views if I actually go into my creator studio and have a look, because obviously this subscribers does not always come up on the subscribers don't come up on YouTube straight away. It's very stupid. I don't know why that is how it is, but that's just what they put it. Yeah, overall I've got over 2k views, so I thank you guys for that so very much. But we do have 72 subscribers. Okay. Make sure you comment and subscribe. Go be a great mate to someone else, because you are all my best mates. Have a good day. Later.